Welcome along to another Biggles video, and in this one I'm raiding the archives and we're going back to the year 2000 with some footage I took in Hitchin Street Biggleswade of the Berkeley Coachworks Factory, not only the factory but the outbuildings and also the sports and social club. Now some of you may be thinking, how can you do that? Because the place closed down in 1960. Well, yes, you'd be right, it did. However, I'd had a tip-off that most of the buildings were still there, and some of them in the original condition from the 1950s. So let's get in there quick. The bulldozers are moving in, and let's see what's left. So here's the Berkeley factory site. All this brick front would have been put on after Berkeley's, of course, in the 1970s. A company called Abbas had this building for a while, and you can just, if you have a look on the top right hand corner of the brickwork, you can just make out the shadow of Abbas where the big sign was. Coming up on the left hand side here, Expandex, that was another company that was in this building. I think that they made files for offices, you know, cabinets, filing cabinets. I think they made the files and maybe the cabinets. This is a view from the railway footbridge over the Biggleswade to London railway line, and the Berkeley factory is to the right of those three new buildings. The pitched roof, look to the right, and you can see a black building with a curved top, and that is the old Berkeley factory. All those other buildings were built in more recent times, especially the huge building in the forefront there. And here is the Berkeley building, the original Berkeley building, and it's pretty much as it would have been back in the 1950s with the windows and the doors. Behind a couple of units now coming into view is a huge boiler. We'll see that in a moment. This is the inside of the factory, and this is pretty much as it would have been back in the 50s. The roof, it looks pretty original. I would imagine it would be green, the same colour as this, and it's extremely light in here. There's no lights on, it's just the light coming through the glass in the roof there. These are the original meters and amp meters. The power supply for the whole factory, and a scan across. We're now looking through to the back of the factory. There's the back door and those windows. The ladies, it's all bricked up, no longer in use. And the gents, that's all bricked up too. Here's another shot of the roof, and it's a fantastic structure. There was another one of these buildings, but that was burnt down in a huge fire in 1952, and in that other building it was totally destroyed. All these girders ended up all twisted and bent and horrible. I'll show you some pictures of the Great Fire in the next video. Here's some of the water taps and things that were in the building, and also there was a huge sprinkler system. I guess that was installed after that fire of 1952. This is part of the sprinkler system. That huge tank is a big water tank for the sprinkler system. Here's the section that's along parallel to the main Berkeley building. I don't know what this was used for, but obviously something that needed a lot of light. It may have been a drafting office, I've no idea. Maybe you know. If you do, comment below. And here's that boiler that is outside, just out the back of the building. I don't know whether this is original from the 1950s. This is another shot of it as some of the brickwork's taken down, and another room next to it there. So this is the original Berkeley building. Now that the newer buildings have been demolished, this is what it would have looked like when it was the Berkeley factory, manufacturing caravans and cars.
This shot shows a little bit more as it's demolished. All the side wall of the Berkeley factory is now knocked out, and the factory roof is standing on its own. It's self-supporting off these huge girders. It doesn't need the side walls at all to hold it up. It's a complete self-supporting roof. And that's so you can see the end's also been knocked out there. And as we go inside, you can now see those girders holding the roof up with all the side and the end wall completely removed. Here's some outbuildings. I'm not sure what they were used for, but a lot of paint on this one. It looks like a test spray. Maybe it was used for painting, I don't know. This is another one of the outbuildings, the roof, the asbestos roof, because a lot of asbestos on this lot. That's all been removed so we can actually see a little bit clearer what's going on inside. Coming up in a moment, you'll see a slot in the wall, like a huge letterbox. And if you've got any comments on the letterbox, if you know what it may have been used for, I'd be really interested to know, because it was a bit of a mystery. It ran between that room with the test spray paint on the wall and this room here. It must have been put in the wall for some purpose. Another outbuilding, and again this has got the asbestos roof and the asbestos cladding on the side. These buildings look as though they could possibly have been used for storage. On the left coming up now is the original sports and social club. And this building, it's amazing, it's still there, everything's still there. Here we are, nicely clad in asbestos. This is the Berkeley Sports and Social Club building, and it's been boarded up inside, but apart from that, it's more or less as it was left. I went here once for a Christmas party because my dad worked at Berkeley's, and I do remember going there when I was very small, but there was a Christmas party in this building for kiddies of the families that worked at Berkeley's. Back in the old days, most of my friends' parents worked at Berkeley's, so we were all here together. This is the rear view. And from a bit further away, this ground on the right at the back here of the Sports and Social Club, I was told was a nice little sports ground where maybe football and things like that were played. So let's go inside and see what we can find. This is the main building inside. I'm standing on the stage of the Sports and Social Club. At this end, it's quite light because there are some windows in the roof. Looking towards the kitchen end, there are the serving hatches there, glazed serving hatches in front. It's a little bit dark, and this is a still that I took, which just shows a little bit more of the building. And again, looking across the end where the kitchen is, there's the hatches where the food and the drink would have been served. That is the stage where bands would have performed and speeches made. And here's are intrepid trespassers. I'm on the left, Russell in the middle, and Malcolm on the right. This is inside the kitchen now, and the other side of those serving hatches. That's where the stuff would have been, plates, drink or whatever, would have been kept in those units there. So there we are. Now let's get up to date. So this is the view at the end of 2020. From the other angle. There is a Berkeley close, but unfortunately it's nowhere near the old factory. It's on the site of Kaiser Bondor, the factory used to be here, and from here the Berkeley site is quite a long way up the road, way up there. Here's the view from the railway footbridge, and it's just a sea of houses.
Well, I hope you've enjoyed our look back at Berkeley Coachworks in Hitchin Street, Biggleswade. The factory closed just before Christmas in 1960, making everyone redundant. And I do remember this because my dad and uncle worked there, and I remember my dad turning up on our doorstep with his toolbox in his hand with words of, "I need to find another job." In the next video, I'm planning to show you some pictures of Berkeley cars running around in this local area, the caravans, the big fire of 1952, some of the workers at the factory, a couple of Christmas parties I've got pictures of, and also I have some memorabilia that I salvaged from the factory just before those bulldozers moved in. If you've got any pictures you'd like including in the next video, do get in touch with me. I'd particularly like a picture of the factory from the road, the front picture. I don't have a picture of the factory from the road. So if you enjoyed this video, please like, comment and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.